Sydney property prices are defying a national downturn, but only the city's richest suburbs are getting cheaper.
For plenty of sellers, Sydney's housing market is as soggy as the harbour city itself. The high-end property boom has turned to bust. Artist Wendy Gallen has just sold her property, a Victorian terrace in Petersham, at a discount.
Oh, about $40,000, I think. Yeah.
For home buyers, current market conditions are perfect.
It is certainly a buyer's market out there. We're seeing stock levels about 30% higher than what they were at the same time last year.
Giving buyers both time and choice.
Buyers are maybe finding that things aren't as urgent, so they're taking longer to make their mind up.
Agents report clearance rates are down, but demand remains, evidenced by the latest RP Data home value research. In Sydney, house prices lifted in April by a modest 0.3% and added just 1.2% over 3 months. The average house price here sits at $515,000. Nationally, though, it's a different story, with an average loss of 1.2% recorded over the 3 months.
New South Wales will still be strong. It was predicted because it stayed lower during the last cycle. Brisbane, Perth of suffering because they increased significantly last cycle.
The interest rate forecast is equally as bleak. It's been on the sidelines for 6 months, but the Reserve Bank has signalled it can't wait much longer before lifting rates again.
Meaning more will need to be put aside for that rainy day.
Some people adjust for it, others decide not to do anything about it. It will have an impact on prices.
Jacqueline Maddock, 10 News.